teach me.
I also want to let you know about a couple of things I've been thinking about. The first is that James Edward Gray, who wrote the library, he's one of the organizers of the Red Dirt Ruby Conference in Oklahoma. Anyway, he and I are putting together a panel of Rubyists that are going to talk about stuff that's related to Ruby and Rails and just some of the things that are going on in the community. We have Aaron Patterson and Peter Cooper and David Brady, who are also going to be on the show. And it's really just going to be, we're hoping to have it be kind of a fun thing and an informative thing. So we're actually going to do our first show a week from today. And we're going to call it Ruby Rogues. I should have the Ruby Rogues website up here within the next few days. And hopefully then people can start subscribing to the podcast and getting all the great material there. I'm also thinking about starting, in fact, I'm going to have a Ruby summer camp, a Rails summer camp. And basically it's an online event. It's going to run for between 6 and 8 weeks, probably 8 weeks. I'm going to go into as much depth as I can on Ruby in that time, and I'm going to have videos, I'm going to have written materials, I'm going to have links out to other community sites that explain one guy who has actually posted some videos on teachmetocode.com, and he recommended to me that I talk to a recruiter. And so he referred me to this recruiter, and the recruiter found me a client. And I'm still working for that client, actually. Work for that client 2 days a week. And the client's actually an excellent client. The project was started by Pivotal Labs, and it's a relatively interesting project. So anyway, that also worked out pretty well, and so now I'm the primary contractor on that project, and I do all the maintenance on that. And you know, maintenance meaning that. And then the other thing that has really worked out for me, and this is the real secret sauce. If you want to find
interestingly enough, it worked out that being involved in the community and getting to know some of the developers in the community allowed me to then become involved with the right people who knew where the work was. So if you're looking for work and you're interested in local work, that's a great way to go. Find a user group or start a user group. Find the people who are involved in the community that know everybody, or that are usually the same people who are organizing the meetups, and then take advantage of them and actually go to them and say, hey, I'm going to do some work. think you know at this point, and inevitably you'll still find something. Especially in a case that an area of mine where there's so much reading on your work. So then, the next thing that I wanted to talk about was, making contacts. So reach out to other people in the community. Now, this podcast has been a really good vehicle for that. Now, not just because I haven't really reached out to people. I've actually been emailing people this morning, but I wasn't feeling terrific today, so I didn't line anything up. It works out really well if you know other people on the community. And, you know, it's just really just fascinating. You know, you make these contacts, you get to know people, you do the right things so that they trust you. And it's not that you're doing the right things so that they'll trust you. It's you're doing the right things and then they trust you. And it works out so that, you know, you gain enough contact and context with these people that you get your skills and you can trust them. And so, you know, it's really been fascinating.